Now, Dana, you're my assistant manager, so I'm counting on you to run a tight ship.
No problem. You're the boss.
That's right. I'm the boss. I own this place. I bought it with my wife's money.
Oh, will she be coming down here too?
No, never. She'd kill me if she knew I bought a restaurant. She thinks I bought a photomat booth.
You mean you're never going to tell her about the cafe?
Oh, I will, but after this is a big success, and that's where you come in.
I'll do my best.
Now, I know Karen and JT are your family, but you're in charge. So as long as you're here, you have to pretend you're not related to them.
Wait a second. I get paid to pretend I'm not related to JT? Hmm? Talk about your dream job.
Well, what do you think, Mr. Passarelli?
Karen, that is a great look for the restaurant.
And even more important, it's a great look for me.
That must be the DJ I hired. Hi.
Hey, sorry, Mr. P. I'll fix those brakes right after work.
Mr. Passarelli, are you sure you hired the right guy to be your DJ?
Of course he's the right guy. He's working for free.
Hey, I'd pay to work this job. I get to listen to 50s tunes. I get to dress like my idol. What's his name?
The Fonz? Whoa.
No, Ed down at the Texaco station. Did you know that he lifted a car off another mechanic's legs with his bare hands? Of course, if he'd have looked before he backed up, he wouldn't have parked on the other guy's legs in the first place.
Well, I gotta go. I'm taking my wife.
What is this? A mannequin festival? There are people out there who need service.
Hey, give us a break. We're doing the best we can.
Well, your best stinks.
Yeah, well, not as much as working for you.
Hey, you can't talk to me like that. I'm your boss.
Not anymore. I quit.
Me too.
Here, now I think you know what to do with this.
Here. Karen, are you quitting?
You bet I am.
Then we quit too.
What?
The only reason we put up with you is so we could look at Karen.
Wow, how about that? I'm a fringe benefit.
Wait a minute. You guys don't have to quit. Karen, you've got to come back to work.
No way.
Please, you're my sister.
Oh, no. Not here. Here, I am just your employee. Your slow employee who happens to be free tonight if anyone's interested.
I'm interested, too.
I'm out of here, too. Hasta la vista, baby.
Mom, I am dying here. You've got to help me out.
You want us to wait tables?
Please, I'd do it for you.
No, you wouldn't.
Okay, I wouldn't, but this is your chance to teach me how to be a better person.
Oh, come on, Frank. She needs some help.
Okay.
Frankie, Annette, what is this, a beach party? We've got work to do. Let's move that poodle skirt.
Or we'll deal with her right now.
Oh, Dana, can I speak to you for a minute, please? We have a little problem that only the assistant manager can handle.
What's the problem?
The assistant manager.
Hey, what's this? Calm down.
Dana, we are your parents, and we don't like the way you're treating us.
I'm sorry, but I can't treat you like parents. I have to treat you like employees. I'm the boss.
Yeah, but Dana, being the boss doesn't mean bossing everyone around. Frank and I wouldn't dream of treating our employees the way you do. In fact, if we did, we wouldn't have any employees.
Have I been that bad?
Well, let me put it this way, Dana. If this were the land of Oz, a big house would have dropped on you.
Hi, Dana. How's it going? Everything under control?
Whoa! Fire! Oh, don't worry. I got it all under control. Everything's okay. Okay. Is there anybody out there that likes their burgers really, really well done?